How's it going, YouTubes? Undying out, bringing you another custom showcase. Today we have an experiment with the review. I cannot move this camera whatsoever, otherwise you're going to see the outside. So it's literally going to have to be stuck in one position. So we'll see how this goes, but this is my Star Wars Black Series, the Bad Batch custom Imperial Crosshair. It is the base body, it's the standard Black Series Imperial Crosshair, but with new knee pads, new shoulder pads. I think I modified the elbow, I can't remember. Repainted the helmet, repainted the whole body, and also gave him a custom head. So without further ado, let's get into it. So I repainted the whole figure. I can't remember what greys I used, it was ages ago, and then scuffed up with lead belcher and a eye painter silver. And then I also painted the green lenses with Tamiya clear green instead of the weird matte paint that they used. And then these are 3D printed knee pads, and these shoulder pads are 3D printed and held on by elastic. And I did cover up the Hunter ports there from the reuse that Hasbro used. And yeah, pretty happy with this. So helmet does come off, but I don't really like unhelmeted heads, so this is just filled with blue tack. And now we'll take a look at the unmasked head sculpt. So here is my unmasked Imperial Crosshair. I liked in the episode when he got attacked by the ship thrusters, but then they resolved the episode in the next episode. He had like a tiny cut here, and I was like, that doesn't make any sense. You got immolated by a cruiser. Like, you should be absolutely messed up. So I decided to do my own version. And as you can see, he's definitely got scorched or immolated by that ship. Really happy with the colours of the burn. I tried to look at actual pictures of burn marks and stuff on people, but it made me feel sick, so I couldn't do that for very long. So I kind of just went with my imagination, but tried to get the colours accurate. I think it looks really cool. Just got into a few size comparisons. So here he is with his fellow Elite Squadron. I do have a third one, but I need to paint the flamethrower and also need to paint the markings on him, because I still haven't done that. And also I've lost where the body is, so I've only got two for now, but he looks cool getting flanked by troopers. And then here he is, my custom Bad Batch. This is the custom Hunter, which is completely repainted. A new 3D printed blaster, because it's the accurate size, and a 3D printed helmet, which is smaller and accurate to the show. And then on the right hand side we have the Bad Batch Crosshair, which is basically just the normal Crosshair, but I gave him Death Trooper legs and then tried to match the look from the show on the Death Trooper, which was a pain in the ass, but I gave it my best shot. So that's why the Crosshairs are a little bit smaller than each other, although I don't know if they are with the helmets off. With the helmets on, I should say. I shouldn't have done this one-handed. Yep, I knew that was gonna happen. So yeah, Bad Batch Crosshair is slightly taller because he's using Death Trooper legs, but doesn't really bother me, as I'm never gonna have two Crosshairs stood next to each other, because that wouldn't make any sense. And lastly, here is the Black Series Stormtrooper and the Black Series... No, hang on. Marvel Legends Punisher. So I hope you enjoyed this episode of Custom Showcase. Please hit like button if you did and dislike if you didn't. Let me know what you think of my figure. I'm really happy with the especially unmasked head sculpt. Trying to sculpt that ear was a pain in my ass, but it worked out. The other thing is, what do you think of having Darth Vader sat there in the background? Does it distract from the custom, or does it just add like a cool little, not Easter egg, but I don't know what you'd call it, add a piece to the diorama where there's someone just sat in the background kind of watching? But yeah, enjoy the photos at the end, and I'll catch you in the next video. Peace.